perception check.
Okay.
Okay. On the other question, what can be done? Well, you know, everything can be done. Everything can be done up to the point of eliminating all structures of authority and repression. They're all created. They're human institutions. They can be dismantled. If you ask yourself what's the most important, well, you know, that's not the kind of thing you decide. Meeting like this. Under those conditions, by serious flaws, people are trying to change. Well, you know, typically, you know, given the world the way it is, you start with what the world is. Okay. Like, you don't start by saying, what's the world of the corporation? I think that's what the most is not being arranged. So you start with saying, well, here's what the world is. What can we do? Well, you begin to do things to get people to understand better what the source of real power is and just how much they can achieve. Like, you can start by, say, first of all, you can start by getting us to stop working. But the easy way to do it is to stop killing people, stop the natural brains, those reasons. So let's do that. With regard to the masculine scene, they say the crime bills. I mean, they're just, like I said, they're the domestic equivalent of death squad. The fact that they're part of the population, people under military occupation, look, that's an easy decision. I mean, you're really going to have to change that. You aren't striking for subscribing power. You need to have a civilized criminal system instead of a brutal barbaric. So that's a change. What about the war against children and families? Another case that I mentioned. Well, that's not as easy. The European Japanese war, and except Paris there. But those are countries very much like us. You know, they have the same institutions, the same economy, and so on and so forth. They have simply, you know, not just unilateral business power as much as here for historical reasons. And we can certainly become like those countries. You know, there's a model right in front of you, very much like us. But they say no. Well, you know, the U.S. Gulf has been going after too. Again, I think for the same reason. I mean, even if it's really a couple of miles north, well, there's a country very much like us, which has to do with civilized, again, plenty of things wrong with it, but assembly civilized, healthcare, not that far back in the 1960s, under conditions we need. Well, that was one of the things that I don't want to say that it's a disease, so we're brain. Like gas, are you getting heart disease? Because here, crucial interest of authoritarian heart disease. And then you're going to be in the state of that. You can't go into the fact that you're in the state. But being the most authoritarian in human history, or certainly close to it, is a corporation. It's an institution in which authority goes strictly from top to bottom. If you're ultimately it's an hands of ownership vested. If you're inside the system, you take orders from above and transmit them down. If you're outside the system, there are very weak popular controls, which indeed are eroding. I should say that this is not an inside of mind. It was pointed out by Thomas Jefferson in his later years when he warned, the early days of corporations, he warned that if power was going to shift again, but he told banks and money corporations, then the democratic system would bring you back into the form of absolutism, of course, what they struggled against. Thomas Jefferson is not exactly a figure of self-respecting in American history. So it's not a new insight. It's an American adaptive lie. We should recognize what Thomas Jefferson could see in effect there outside. But when you see that, you realize that it's a part of it. Because there are enormous corporations of power. And
Right. And his words are not true. But that was before telegraph.